Hey everyone, it's Victoria with Nutrition by Victoria, and welcome to part two of What to Eat on the Fruit and Veggie Challenge. So today we're going to be talking about vegetables and what to eat on the Fruit and Veggie Challenge. So when I designed this challenge, it's fruit-based, so you're getting most of your calories from fruit, and you can check out part one of this video series in the link down below. And the whole purpose of the fruit being the majority of your calories is this stuff is low in calories, but it's high in volume. So it can fill you up at the end of the day, give you a little bit of a different flavor profile. And from a physiological standpoint, it works in the system as a mechanical broom. So you're eating fruit all day, the sugar is filling your cells, the fruit acid is dissolving away waste and debris that accumulates in the system, dissolving fat that gets pushed out from the fat cells while you're on this protocol. And if you want more information about this process, you can check out the Mucusless Diet Healing System book. I will leave a link for the $7 paperback copy that's available on Amazon. I highly recommend reading the book. It has a lot of great information about how this diet works for improving your health, clearing up any kind of chronic conditions, and losing weight. So this is my version of the Mucusless Diet Healing System. I've developed the Fruit and Veggie Challenge as a method for making the Mucusless Diet System work for you or anybody who wants to try this out. Okay, so the vegetable portion. I generally recommend eating the vegetables at night. Although, if you are coming from a standard American diet and you want to do the Fruit and Veggie Challenge, I highly recommend also having more vegetables with your fruit meals because it will increase your satiety. Vegetables, especially like zucchini, broccoli, asparagus, these are denser foods, so they're gonna help curb cravings. And I even recommend too, if you're coming to this from a standard American diet, you also include things like potatoes as well. So I'm not featuring potatoes here because this is what I'm currently doing, is just doing fruits and non-starchy vegetables. But you can do a raw tofu approach as well and having starches after your vegetable meals. And you'll still get great results. But this protocol maximizes results. So that's what we are going for with this challenge. Again, if you want to know more about why this works, check out the Mucusless Diet Healing System book. It is a transformative read. I think I've read that book about 50 times, and every time I read it, I figure out something new. So, other great resources, Freely, The Banana Girls, old videos from like 5 years ago are great resources. And this methodology of the Fruit and Veggie Challenge is based off of her experience and her Banana Girl diet challenge. It's based off of Durian Rider's protocol, my own experience, and then again the Mucusless Diet Healing System. Okay, so let's get into the foods. So these are some of my favorite vegetables, and again, this is going to be green leafy vegetables as well as cooked non-starchy vegetables, as well as, I believe these are actually culinary fruits, where it's like cooking fruit, some bell peppers, where it's growing on a plant, not a tree, but technically it has seeds, so it's a fruit. Same with zucchinis here. But I generally recommend starting out your vegetable meal with raw salad greens. And if you're not feeling like something too hearty, you can have some celery before your, some celery or some lettuce or a small salad before like a bunch of baked zucchini. And again, if you're doing raw tofu, having like some celery and some lettuce and some baked zucchini with your baked squashes or baked root vegetables. Okay, but this is about what I'm currently doing and this challenge that I'm promoting. So I have a fondness of seaweed. So this is roasted nori seaweed. And again, I'm not all about like everything has to be 100% raw. I'm going for practical application here and what I enjoy food-wise. So that's really how you want to base this challenge, is use your intuition. Eat what tastes good to you. Eat what feels good to you. Experiment. But also, you know, don't force yourself to do anything that doesn't feel good after you've tried it a few times. Okay, so I will generally make nori wraps. These are featured a lot in my What I Eat in a Day videos. I also have some baby greens here. I'm not a big fan of kale, eaten raw, or like some of those heartier greens, the bitter greens, but some nice tender leafy greens. I've got romaine lettuce here, baby spinach. Make a big salad, let those be your base. If you want, you can make wraps with the nori. I love to eat my food in wrap form, so, and I love this. And this gives you kind of like a salty flavor. There's, and this one particularly, it's Anayaki nori. I actually really, my favorite is the Ocean's Halo organic nori. I just didn't have it, it wasn't available when I was at the store last. So I didn't have any, but I like this stuff too. And so it gives you a little bit more of a salty flavor without having to add salt. So that's why I have lemon and lime here too, because this is what I recommend for dressing your salad, as well as things like your cooked vegetables and raisins. I love raisins on a salad. You can also put your bell peppers, your cucumber. I've been making cucumber noodles recently with a spiralizer and putting that on the salad. I really like eating the cucumber that way. And if you're partial to noodles, you can spiralize your zucchini or your cucumber. You can dress your salad with whatever you want, but I recommend not using salt and getting away from condiments that contain vinegar, because vinegar can be a little too acidic on your system. And I know that I have sensitivities to vinegar, and I even have sensitivities to citric acid if I use it too much. So I've learned over time, you know, how much to use. But vinegar has an even more acidic effect on the body, whereas these are just more natural and healthy. I recommend doing the salad portion first and then your cooked vegetables. The method of cooking that I recommend is steaming as well as baking with parchment paper. You can also water saute. So say you want to make a veggie stir fry to go over your salad, which is a great combination salad recipe to use. You could water saute the onion, the bell peppers, zucchini, add some salt-free spices that you like garlic powder, cumin, and there you go. You have a tasty salad, or maybe you want to skip the spices altogether. Spices are optional. You can use them if you like them. Something else I also have here is some mushrooms. Use them if you like them. I'm finding myself not enjoying mushrooms as much as I'm getting further into this challenge, but I do like to add them to a cooked vegetable recipe every once in a while. So you want the emphasis to be on the raw salad, because these greens are, well, the tender raw leafy greens. They are tender enough to not irritate the system too much, but fibrous enough to act as a broom. So when you're eating your food all day, it loosens up any of the waste that gets pushed into the system, because as we are breathing all day long, our pump system is pumping waste out of our cells. That waste travels through our blood, and from our blood, it either ends up back in our gastrointestinal tract, or we urinate the waste out through our kidneys, or we're breathing out carbon dioxide. So our lungs can be an elimination point as well. But you want the fruit to go in and kind of dissolve things up. Fruit acids also will travel through the blood to clean things up you know, in the deeper cellular areas as well. And this cleansing process allows more oxygen to come in, and oxygen is a big cleanser as well. So we're getting a detox effect from this without, you know, having to stress the body out. We're eating nutritious foods. We're eating enough carbohydrates. We're getting healthier in the process by eating really healthy foods and eating plenty of them. After you have your fruit meals and you get this dissolving action going on, then you come and have your salad meal at night with fruit, or just have the vegetables on their own and add in your cooked vegetables. I also have some asparagus here. Asparagus is really good baked. You can also use frozen or canned vegetables as your cooked vegetable option. And you have yourself a really hearty, delicious meal that also acts as a great room to push everything out of the system in a very safe method. And then you take a number two and you feel glorious afterwards. Okay, I'm gonna wrap this video up. Again, you wanna focus on your big salad first, or salad wraps, that's how I like to eat. Then add, if you want as an option, your cooked vegetables. You can also have more fruit before your dinner meal, or have fruit with your salad vegetables. Fruit generally combines well with greens and celery, but not so much like a lot of the cooked stuff. So eat your fruit with your raw leafy greens. And then if you want cooked foods after that, then have those like 20 minutes later. And then if you're still hungry after all that food and you don't want to eat more fruit, because I have eaten like dates after I've had my salad meal and I obviously didn't eat enough calories during the day, because that's usually what happens, is if you don't get in enough fruit and sugar during the day and you eat your non-starchy vegetables at night and your salad, you'll be hungry afterwards because you didn't eat enough during the day. So when you eat enough during the day, you have your salad vegetables and then you're satisfied. If you didn't eat enough, you're gonna want something afterwards. So I recommend having dates, because they generally like will be okay eating them after cooked vegetables, especially non-starchy vegetables. You know, you wanna wait a little bit and then have your dessert. And there won't be so much like of a fermentation reaction. I've even had banana ice cream, and I think as long as you have like a window of like an intermission, you know, between dinner and dessert, you'll be okay. Or if you're on the raw till 4 plan and you're eating starch, that's, you know, when to have your cooked starches after your salad, after your non-starchy vegetables, and then have your starchy vegetables. You know, your root vegetables, your squashes, things like that. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Leave any comments or questions down below. Let me know if you're joining me on the Fruit and Veggie Challenge, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.